selected to run post membership qualifications in 5 subjects from this location, and given the space here, it is possible to run full time integrated residential company secretary course, which we started last year at CCGRT Belapur, and it is scheduled to commence next year from Hyderabad Center of Excellence. The next summation is that this is not the end of our journey. Having this building is not that the job is over. In fact, we have traveled this far, we have much longer to travel. As Lord Buddha told, it is better to travel better than to arrive at the destination. I hope the journey continues and this temple is used for building the profession of company secretaries. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your very warm wishes and also the encouraging announcements about using the opportunity, about the facility here. May I now request CSVP Khare, Vice President ICSI, to address the gathering.
Honorable Chief Guest, Shri D.V. Sadanand Gowda, Minister of Railway Union of India. Today's guest of honor, Honorable Justice M.M. Venkatachalaya, former Chief Justice of India, respected President, my friend and the counselor, Mr. Gopal Krishna Hegde, person behind this project, Team Bangalore chapter, past President Shri D.K. Pranarad Rao, my colleagues on the council and my brothers, sisters of profession and their students. Winston Churchill has said, "We shape our buildings, thereafter they shape us." It's really a beautiful sentence containing a lot of meaning in it. As Mr. Sahu has pointed out, this is the single biggest building which institute has with reference to any chapter or regional council also. I think with this beautiful building, the brand of ICSI has got further value in the corporate world. Friends, any institution, its infrastructure is very, very essential to create lasting back confidence among its stakeholders. In 2011, the council took a bold decision to create infrastructure for chapters and regional council all over India. And this is the outcome of that biggest initiative taken by the council in 2011. And a lot of big projects are coming across India as far as building the infrastructure of ICSI is concerned. Now real challenge starts, because inaugural is only a function, opening function. But if we want to ensure that our dream come true, for the purpose for which we have created this infrastructure, now it is duty of, including the Central Council, including the Regional Council, that this premises will become very, very happening premises as far as our professional activities are concerned. This is 21,000 square feet infrastructure, and big challenge is really ahead to use this infrastructure to the maximum extent. We have to ensure that right from the morning till late evening, there is activity happening in each room, each auditorium, each conference room, so that we will do justice to this infrastructure. We have to have lot of educating and learning experiences for students and members. Companies Act 2013 has thrown open tremendous opportunities as well as challenges before this profession. It is said that empty sack never stands straight. We have to put in a lot of capacity amongst our members, students, and for that purpose, this building, this infrastructure will go a long way by very well knowledgeable company secretaries for corporate world. I appreciate the efforts taken by Team Bangalore under the leadership of Gopal Krishna Hegde, my friend, and I appreciate the support because council only takes policy decision. Yes, Bangalore chapter should have this kind of infrastructure, but later on whole project is managed by our secretariat. So I compliment our secretary Mr. M.S. Sahu, Chief Executive Sutani Sinha, Mr. Pradhan, who is also here, who was doing all the activities with reference to this building, and whole team Bangalore for building this beautiful building. I compliment once again all the team. I also compliment all members and students of Bangalore chapter for believing in and supporting directly or indirectly in building these beautiful premises. So thank you very much. All the best, Bangalore chapter.
Sir, thank you. You rightly refer to the challenges ahead. I agree, we are on a journey. The first destination has been reached. There are several on the way. I can assure you Team Bangalore is prepared for this daunting task. Can I hear a yes from our CS members? Thank you. It is my privilege now to request our President CSR Sridharan to address all of you on this historic occasion.
Minister of Railways Government of India, Sri Sadananda Gowda, Honorable Justice Swayamananda Chalaya, Sri Vikas Kari, Vice President Stude of the Dignities and Dais, my colleague, the Council Sarum Balakrishnan, and past President, past Chairman of the Bangalore Chapter and Chairman of Regional Council, and other dignitaries present here, and professional colleagues and students. Good morning to all of you. Today is the Red Letter Day in the history of the Institute and the Bangalore Chapter. The dream of every university here has come true. 2014 is a historic year for all of us. There are many good things and bad things. And bad things become good things afterwards has taken place in 2014. Before I move on to the how we should make use of this building effectively, I would like to compliment the Bangalore Chapter Building Committee or Infrastructure Committee headed by Sir Gopalakrishna Hegde and all other committee members and the Bangalore Chapter committee members for bringing this historic building to the reality. As the President of the Institute, I played multiple roles as far as this project is concerned. When this building was, the project was conceived in 2011, I was a council member at that point of time. So any project comes from the southern region, see people allocated from the southern region always be enthusiastic to push how fast we can get this project approved by the council. I was also one such person so enthusiastic and this project came for approval by the council, fifth council, and I also joined with the HDC that how fast we can approve this project. The way in which the project was brought in by the Hegde, so all of you should know that. Mr. Hegde brought this project as if this project cannot be approved by the council. He came with a very big project in Bangalore and finally he wanted what we wanted actually was already made up his mind. That is what he was able to assess subsequently. Initially, we came out with a very big project which cost more than 25 crores. I think I don't remember exactly that. So he knows pretty well that the 25 crores will not be approved. Finally, the council will come back, settle down that this is what the project they are approving. So he's already identified the subsequent project. But ultimately, objective is that no one wants to get the things done. I'm proud to say that whatever the proposals brought up by the regional office, Valley Chapter 3 Regional Office, has been approved unanimously by the council. At this point of time, I'd like to thank each and every council member of the Central Council who has supported the whole RKT. Why I'm telling you they should thank at this point of time, this is the first project the Central Council approved such a big project. We have seen that how the project has been approved by the rest of the three institutional bodies, how they are standing today. So we want to pray, as far as this project is concerned, not only this project, any project for that matter, we want to pray as far as possible, not as 100% transparent. So you know that in an institute system, you need to go through many processes. Bangalore committee, then you have to go to infrastructure committee, regional office, executive committee, and goes to council. The process is very big. So each and every project, the possibilities of not approving it. Each and every stage, it will ensure that the project is approved by all the members. So this is the first project. Probably I can say that the project, the cost of 16 crores, including the infrastructure, including the other facilities which are going to come up shortly. The land cost itself approximately 10 crores and odd. And rest of that is the... I was told that 1996 the building was purchased. The presently where we are now presently operating. I think that year is correct. 1996 it was purchased, the 1600 square feet was purchased at that time at a cost of less than 10 lakhs. You know pretty well that the present place where the Palio chapter is functioning, we don't want either our members or the students really want deaths taking place in that place. Probably one of the reasons for the council to take a positive decision to get this project approved is that by seeing the place in which the present Bangalore chapter is functioning, by taking into account the number of members and number of students residing in Bangalore, I think the project was approved in total. I think this the Bangalore chapter definitely has blessed that the council, entire council supports this project irrespective of the cost. So 16 crores is a project as high as there is approval as there is the council is concerned. The first time, in history of the last so many years, such a big project has been approved. And coming back to the utilization of the building. Now you are aware that we have 37,000 members of that institute as on date. We have approximately 7,000 company secretaries are residing from southern region. In Bangalore city alone, approximately 1,600 member secretaries are there. Roughly about 11,000 students of three levels are pursuing this course. Many a times the council discussed how best we can utilize a 21,000 square foot building. You know the maintenance cost also equally tough. And also we have to ensure that the sort of amount of manpower also be prepared so that they should not feel that they are isolated by the council. And today, when I visited, when I was just going through this building, just suddenly idea came to my mind. Thanks to Mr. Sahu was that we are now, this is probably his idea, the coming out of the integrated course, that is not a full-time course, which already started as Mr. Sahu rightly said in his remarks, that he has come out with the full-time classes at CCGRT, Center of Excellence in Bombay, and subsequently I think they are planning to move for Hyderabad, the project is also activated. And morning when I was discussing with the chief executive that why not we quickly complete the hospital facilities here so that this building can also be utilized for conducting integrated course from July onwards. So he came out immediately, why not? Let us take it as a headquarters project. I just saw that from the rear side there are huge vacant land was available. So we thought that why not we do it immediately? The message here is that we want how best we can utilize the building effectively for the benefit of the students, particularly residing from the southern region. There are two big projects for the integrated course is going to be formally launched in July 2015, one in Hyderabad and second one is Bangalore. I think the Bangalore will take a lead than Hyderabad because the Hyderabad project is a big project than Bangalore. Hyderabad they are going for 50,000 square feet. Today I was just recollecting going through the milestone of the institute about 30-35 years back. many businesses are very just learned members are here. You know, the our institute started in 1968 with a small room in Karol Bagh. Initially it was given to MCA. And from MCA, small room to the Karol Bagh small room, then move to the Lodi Road. Today, we are now talking about 21,000 square feet. Today, we are talking about purchase of 50 acres land for purchase of our own capital last week, which was concluded at Kolkata. The theme of the convention was change, challenge, opportunity. All of you are aware change is inevitable. All of you are also aware that the companies are 2013 the challenge. We are also equally aware opportunities available in the companies at 2030. My message to all the members and students here that how best we can make use of this building effectively for the development of the rural professions. Many a times Mr. Sahu, exhibited that many a time lingering in my mind that he said there are two activities which the institute has to perform. One is the development of the profession, second one is the regulation of the professions. The regulation of the professions cannot be done anybody only by regulated only by the institute. Whereas the development of professions can be done by anybody, which many places are taking place, various seminars and workshops. So this building, which all of us believe this is a temple for our growth, and always believe that what Hindi folk said, coming together is a beginning, staying together is a progress, working together is success. The working together success is now the day the exhibitors that we have the building today. So every one of you, every committee members, every council members, everybody has worked together as a team and see the dream of the Bangalore chapter members now come true. Friends, today the company secretary is elevating the level of key managerial personnel under the Companies Act 2013. Company secretary in practice now has been designated as a secretary auditor under the Companies Act 2013. There are certain type of companies required to have a secretary audit done by a company secretary in practice. The functions of the company secretaries under Scope 2013 very clearly define what is the role the company secretary has to play in employment. The functions not only talks about the governance, it also talks about the applicable laws, whether the system is in place. So, I strongly believe that the building which has now has been formally inaugurated, every day there should be some activities should take place. So that we need to understand that today we are in a different situation what we were about a year back. Today every one of us ensure that we always believe that the Companies Act is a core subject for us. We need to understand that today is the challenge for the institute for this year is to create a capacity building across the country. So we are organizing various seminars, workshops across the country to create a capacity building for our own members so that they will not miss the opportunity what is available in the Companies Act 2013. At the same time, we should also ensure that we are capable of delivering whatever has been expected by the regulators, which has been very clearly defined in the Companies Act 2013. Friends, challenges now that opportunities are plenty. And only just my advice to all the members here, please make use of this building effectively. We have spent a huge amount. We have invested 16 crores for the 11,000 members, 11,000 students and about 1,600 members. Every member, every student should look at this as a temple and may visit this temple regularly and make use of the building effectively so that we will ensure that the knowledge is always is there. I think I cannot talk like how Gopalakrishnan just talked about this. He has just narrated how the building has been structured. But definitely, knowledge is only investments where you will get the best return of interest. Please don't hesitate to spend money as far as the knowledge is concerned. Please try to participate as many programs as possible organized by the Bangalore chapter so that the building can be effectively utilized. We are also contemplating some of the activities that quarters can also be decent rise can be shifted to Bangalore. One such initiative Mr. Sahu was telling that post-management course. The post-management course now is consisting of about 2 papers now we are council has to approve for 5 more papers which has been included as a electives for the final level. That has also been now will be included as a post-management course. You know that today we are now, every one of us now thinking of being appointed as independent directors. Another such initiatives by the institute is that now taking all the 3 institutes together, create a common platform and also come out with a common portal for our own members to be an independent directors. So you can also now think of now becoming independent directors. I was told approximately 60,000 independent directors to be appointed for more than about 20,000 companies now, as per the statistics. So each and every one of you sitting here, make use of this opportunity, get yourself trying. Think yourself, think big, think in a macro level, from the pre-certification, from the secretary auditor, now think of becoming independent directors. If if you want to think like to be independent director of the board, I think this step will help you to get considerable knowledge and strength so that you can play as an independent director. Friends, before I conclude, I like to personally thank Mr. Gopalakrishna today. Since I told you I played a three level of course, today I am standing before you as a president of the institute. Every time, in fact, I was supporting this Hegde, but the strain undergone by Hegde is remarkable. Both physical, mental, whatever you call it as, I think he deserves a good number of applause on all the participants here. I have closely associated with him as this project is concerned. I know the strain undergone by him mentally is definitely, I think, nobody can comment that it is a mental strain undergone by him. Equally, I would like to compliment our officers from the Institute, Secretary and the CE, who has played a supportive role and ensured that the project has come out at the appropriate time. There is another person, backbone, who has ensured that there is not even a single deviation of this, any of the activities. Even the small deviation will ensure that we bring it to notice of the either this committee, that committee, or the executive committee. None other than Mr. Pradhan, who is just sitting here. Please, Pradhan, just rise, just show your face, all the members. So we have the director of infrastructure. I think these are the three pillars of the institute has ensured that taking the vision of the institute to the next level. Friends, today we are now a key managing president, we are a second auditor. This is the right time, I think the right time, the building has come up. This is a probably can say that many good things are taking place this year. One such a good thing is the building has come up. Probably